Hello students, welcome in the PhD lecture. In previous lecture, we had discussed the third process of water purification, that is the sedimentation. What is the sedimentation? Sedimentation is the process of reducing turbidity of water by removal of suspended impurities so that the suspended impurities or particles may be settled down at the bottom due to the force of gravity. See, this is the process of sedimentation. The water containing insoluble impurities, then these impurities are settled at the bottom and clear water is remain at the top of the surface or top of the tank. Then we had discussed the objects of sedimentation. Then we had start the methods of sedimentation. There is a two methods of sedimentation. In that, first method is plain sedimentation. This is we have discussed in previous lecture. What is the plain sedimentation? The plain sedimentation is the process of removing suspended matter from water by keeping it in tanks so that suspended matters may settle down at the bottom due to the force of gravity. Then we had discussed the advantages of plain sedimentation. This is the sedimentation tank. Then we had discussed the process of plain sedimentation. Now in today's lecture, we are going to discuss the sedimentation with coagulation. This is the second method of sedimentation, that is the sedimentation with coagulation. The coagulation process is we are going to explain in next part. Now just see the sedimentation with coagulation. What is the sedimentation with coagulation? Means the process of sedimentation and process of coagulation are takes place simultaneously at a one time, that is the sedimentation with coagulation. Now see what is the necessity of sedimentation with coagulation. The first requirement or necessity of sedimentation with coagulation is very fine suspended particles are not removed by plain sedimentation. It required a 3 to 4 days for settling. That is the very fine particles or impurities are required a 3 to 4 days for settling, and it will be not removed by the plain sedimentation. Hence, it required the sedimentation with coagulation. Then the second necessity is the settling time is impracticable because water can not be settled for long time. That is, this settling time of 3 to 4 days in plain sedimentation is impracticable because the water is not allowed to set for 3 to 4 days. It is a very long time period. Hence, the sedimentation with coagulation is required. Then the third necessity is the clay particles of size 0.06 mm required 10 hours for settle in 3 meter deep tank, and particles of size 0.002 mm required 4 days for settling in plain sedimentation process. Hence, the sedimentation with coagulation is required. That is, the clay particles of 0.06 mm size required 10 hours for settling in 3 meter deep tank, and the particles of 0.002 mm required 4 days for settling in plain sedimentation. This time is a very long time. Hence, the sedimentation with coagulation is required for settlement of these particles. Hope you all get the necessity of sedimentation with coagulation. Now see what is the process of sedimentation with coagulation. In the process of sedimentation with coagulation, sedimentation and coagulation process acting simultaneously one after another. That is the process of sedimentation plus process of coagulation are acting simultaneously one after another in one tank. Then the second point is coagulants such as the ferrous sulfate or alum are added to water when sedimentation process is going on. That is a while the sedimentation process is going on, that is a the settlement of the particles or impurities by the gravitational force is going on, then at this time the coagulant like ferrous sulfate or like alum is added into the sedimentation process, and these two processes are acts simultaneously. When certain chemicals are added, then the particles are colloidal in of the colloidal impurities are formed and this removed by from water. That is the when the alum or ferrous sulfate or any chemical is added into the sedimentation process, then colloidal impurities are formed. That is the impurities are clogged and it form a or it clots or the all the particles or impurities, and then this removed from water. This is the process of sedimentation with coagulation. In this process, first sedimentation and coagulation processes are act simultaneously after one another. Then coagulants such as the ferrous sulfate or alum are added to water then when sedimentation process is going on. Then when certain chemicals are added, then the particles are colloidal, impurities are formed and then these are removed from water. This is the process of sedimentation with coagulation. Now see what is the most common coagulants which is used in this process. The first coagulant is aluminate sulfate. For the sedimentation with coagulation, the first coagulant is used is aluminate sulfate. Then second is ferric sulfate in combination with lime. Then third is ferric sulfate and fourth is polyelectrodes. Polyelectrodes are also used for the coagulation or sedimentation with coagulation. These four are the coagulants which can be used for the sedimentation with coagulation. Now see what is the coagulation process. Now we had discussed the sedimentation with coagulation process. Now see what is the concept of coagulation. Now see what is the principle of coagulation. The principles of coagulation is individual particles combined together in the coagulation. That is the two or more particles are combined and form one particle. This process is the process of coagulation. If the coagulants are used in water, it forms spongy gelatinous participates, and these participates absorb the fine particles in water and bind them together. This will be form a bigger mass of particles which are easily settleable. That is the coagulant like alum or ferrous sulfate is added into the water, then it forms the spongy gelatinous participate. That is the gelatinous participate is formed, and this participate absorbs all fine particles or the impurities of the water, and this gelatinous participates and fine particles are bind together and form a bigger mass of particle, and which is a easily settleable due to force of gravity. This is the principle of coagulation. Now see what is the processes of coagulation. Coagulation is done by following processes. The first process of coagulation is feeding, then second is mixing, then flocculation, and then clarification and sedimentation. Now don't confuse here. First we had seen the process of sedimentation with adding the coagulant, that is the sedimentation with coagulation. Now we are going to discuss the only process of coagulation, and the in the process of coagulation there is a four parts or four processes. First is feeding, then mixing, then flocculation, and third fourth is clarification and sedimentation. Now we are going to see the first process of coagulation, that is a feeding. Now see what is the feeding. Feeding means the to feed the coagulant to the water. There is a two types of feeding. First is a dry feeding and second is the wet feeding. Now see what is a dry feeding. The dry feeding are used the two common devices for dry feeding, that is a toothed fill device and helical screw device. For dry feeding we are used toothed fill device and helical screw device. Now see, each unit is provided with the conical hopper tanks. Coagulant is powdered and placed in the conical hopper tank and allowed to in making basin, that is the coagulant in the form of dry, that because it is a dry feeding, and this powdered coagulant are placed in a conical hopper and this is allowed to go into the basin, and from this basin it is mixed into the water. This is the dry feeding of the coagulant. Then agitation plates are provided inside the tank for preventing the arching of powdered chemical, that is the agitation plate is provided to make the disturbance to the powdered coagulant or powdered chemical, because by this agitation the powdered coagulant are slowly goes into the water. Then the speed of toothed wheel or helical wheel screw device regulates to dose of the coagulant, that is a to give proper dose of the coagulant, the speed of toothed wheel or helical wheel screw are regulated. Then mechanism is turn is connected to the mixer device in the mixing. Now see, this is the toothed wheel and this is the helical screw which can be used for the dry feeding of coagulant. In this toothed wheel the coagulant is in powder form or are passed by this agitation plate, and this agitation plate are opposed or which can be make disturbance to the coagulant. Then this is a conical hopper. By this conical hopper the coagulant is passed through toothed wheel, and this toothed wheel are spin process. The toothed wheel are in spin process and the coagulant from this toothed wheel are going to the mixing channel, and from mixing channel the coagulant are mixed to the water. Then second is a helical screw. Now see, sorry for disturb. Second is the helical screw. Now in helical screw, one helical screw with driving unit are provided, and when coagulant are passed through the conical hopper it can be passed to mixing channel through this helical screw, and the flow of coagulant is adjusted by this helical screw. Hope you all get this process of dry feeding. Now in next lecture we are going to see the process of wet feeding. Now we are just revise the part of this lecture. In this lecture we had see the process of sedimentation with coagulation. Then we had see the necessity of sedimentation with coagulation. What is the necessity of sedimentation with coagulation? Then we had discussed the process of sedimentation with coagulation. Then we had discussed the most commonly used coagulants. There is a four coagulants which is most commonly used. The first is aluminate sulfate, second is ferrous sulfate in combination with lime, third is ferric sulfate, and fourth is polyelectrodes. Then we had discussed the coagulation process. What is the coagulation process? If the coagulant are used in water, it forms spongy gelatinous particles, and these participants absorb the fine particles in water and bind them together. These form a bigger mass of particles. It's called as a coagulation. Then we had discussed what are the processes of coagulation. There is a four processes of coagulation. First is feeding, second is mixing, third is flocculation, and fourth is clarification with sedimentation. Now we had discussed the first process, that is the feeding. The feeding has two processes, that is the dry feeding and wet feeding. Now see, the dry feeding is used the two common devices, that is the toothed wheel device and helical screw device. Now see, this is a toothed wheel device and it is a helical screw device. And the process of wet feeding is we are going to discuss in next lecture. Hope you all get this process of coagulation and first process of feeding, that is a dry feeding. Thank you.